Good evening. Welcome to River Fire 2006. I'm Bruce Page.
And I'm Heather Ford from National 9 News. Isn't this so exciting? Thank you for joining us for what has to be the most spectacular night of the year for our beautiful River City.
Yeah, just before we go on, happy birthday.
Oh, thank you.
22.
Yes. 41?
Oh,
I can admit that. That's fine. But it's nice of them to put on 80,000 fireworks just for my birthday.
It's pretty special, isn't it?
It's very nice of them, yeah.
Mate, we should also say hi to everyone watching us on the Wind Television Network throughout Queensland. Now, if you haven't seen River Fire before, then you are in for a treat. Also, the four presenters from Channel 9's The Kids Show, The Shack, they'll be dropping in to help out as well.
They're great talent. Now, very soon, Brisbane really will be the city of blinding lights. Our coverage of the fireworks will be live and commercial free and simulcast on FM radio on Triple M.
Once again, we'll see and hear the spectacular dump and burn from the crowd favourites, the RAAF's F-111 fighter bombers.
They are amazing. The F-111s will turn 19 today as they thunder through
just up there
in from the south and then light the wick, so it'll be fantastic.
Now, each has a crew of two sitting up front having all the fun, but it takes more than a pilot and a navigator to get them into the air. A very curious Drew Jarvis went out to meet some of the behind-the-scenes workers who keep those big birds flying.
F-111 was introduced into the RAAF back in 1973. 33 years later, even people who don't know much about aircraft recognise this swing-wing fighter bomber. Their home base is Ambley, near Ipswich, and these fast movers are a familiar sight in the skies of southeast Queensland. In Australian military and aviation circles, the F-111 is affectionately known as the Pig, because of its ability to hunt with its nose in the weeds, referring to the F-111's unique terrain-following ability.
When the F-111 is streaking towards South Bank, the crew will be using this amazing technology. They'll be relying on a radar system housed here in the nose to get them on target and on time. Once the aircraft is over the river, all the action will take place at the other end. As far as the F-111 crew are concerned, this is where the fire part of River Fire happens. With a flick of a switch in the cockpit, fuel is vented through this pipe and is ignited by the hot jet engines. The result? That huge flame we all love, the dump and burn. Can't wait to see it again.
This year, crews from No. 6 Squadron will be doing the dump and burn over the river. The pilots and navigators get to fly the mission, but back at base, there's a whole team of people that make sure the aircraft are hot to trot. Guys like leading aircraftman Jeb Walton are there to make sure everything goes to plan.
So Jeb, what's involved in preparing the aircraft for River Fire?
Well, we have to come in, we have to refuel the aircraft, we have to do a BF, which is a before flight servicing, so checking all your oils, everything to do with the aircraft structure, and if everything's good, we can launch it.
It's a big responsibility. There are about 230 personnel devoted to keeping the 9 F-111s of No. 6 Squadron up in the air. Okay, we've met the ground crew. Time to meet the people who'll be sitting in the cockpits. They're in here planning the mission right now. Bringing two fast-moving jets low over the city at night requires a lot of planning and skill.
Same track, same profile, same targets both times.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yep, and Pete's already bagged the strobridge.
The crews will have done a dry run in daylight, but they can also practice in the F-111 flight simulator. Flight Lieutenants Pete Lambert, the pilot, and Navigator Suze Youngman are really looking forward to lighting up the river.
So how do you get chosen for the River Fire mission?
They share it around because it's a good gig to get, so generally only get to do it once, so pretty happy to be doing it this time.
Yeah, definitely. I grew up in Brisbane, so I've always seen it as a young kid. It's something I've always wanted to do, and this is my lucky time to do it. Impress the friends.
Whose responsibility is it to make sure the dump and burn happens in the right spot at the right time?
Crew effort, but the pilot's there for timing. So if we're late, that's the pilot's fault. And if we miss where the bridge is, that's the nav's fault.
So you're both to blame.
Exactly.
That's right.
Team effort.
I'm sure Susan Pete will do the squadron proud tonight. But apart from the ground crew, there'll be others at Ambley watching after them. The guys of 44 Wing Air Traffic Control.
Well, we're basically responsible for getting the aircraft airborne, identified. They'll usually hang out to the west of Ambley for a little bit while they set themselves up to, timing for the run. and then we hand them off to the civilian counterparts over working in Brisbane. Yeah, basically 7 miles to the east of us, we hand them off, and yeah, we just sit back and watch the show.
Everyone out here at Amberley is ready for river fire. The crew chief has the aircraft in top form, the flight crew have planned the mission down to the last detail, and air traffic control are ready for launch. The only thing left to do now is kick the tires and light the fire.
Well, it certainly is a team effort to get the F-111s ready for river fire, and they will be right on the money, I'm sure. Now, Drew, are you down at South Bank yet?
Well, Bruce and Heather, I'm not actually at South Bank. I've decided to stay here at Amberley and fly the river fire mission myself. Don't panic, it's in the simulator. Have a great river fire, guys.
Well, do enjoy your flight, Drew. Look, I'd love to have a fly in one of those things.
It's a pity there's no back seat, because I would be in it tonight. I would love to do that.
Maybe even the simulator. Do you think if we say it often enough, we might get the message through?
Are they listening?
Yeah. River fire is a brilliant way to kick off River Festival, and people have been out and about making the most of various activities before tonight's fireworks display.
That's right. There's thousands of them have been streaming to the banks of the river and every vantage point around the city all day.
Just over half an hour ago, a couple of Australian Defence Force Iroquois helicopters, Hueys, as we know them, did a run past the city and South Bank. They were built in greater numbers than any military aircraft since World War II, and it's their wide rotor blades that produce that distinctive sound peculiar to the Hueys. Sadly, this will be the last time that they'll be seen at river fire. The Hueys will be decommissioned next year.
They are amazing, aren't they? It was a great noise. Now, to bring you live broadcast of tonight's fireworks, we have cameras everywhere, all on these city buildings that you can see behind us, and in the National 9 News chopper. So let's take a fly downstream from the William Jolly Bridge for a preview of tonight's display. The heart of the city and South Bank will be the main focus, with fireworks from the city buildings, Victoria Bridge, barges in the river, and the Goodwill Bridge. The action then swings to the city reach with more barges, more high-rise firing points, and a stunning display on the Story Bridge. As part of a big finale, the two F-111s will return for another fiery dump and burn.
I got to tell you, I just can't wait either. Wherever you are, get set for a spectacle of sight and sound as we count down to River Fire 2006.
See you soon.
Saw the devastation and knew that we had to do something. So if we can help out fellow Australians, let's do it. And say, look, here you go, no strings attached, it's yours.
Don't miss this wonderful, heartwarming story. National 9 News, Monday at 6.
We've got such a humongous range. It's just enormous. It's huge. Like when I first started, I was thinking, how am I ever going to remember where anything is? Once you've worked at the store for a little while, you can direct them to exactly where they need to go.
Stanley 16-piece screwdriver set, $29.98. Retractable hose reel, $99.95. Multifold ladder, $149. Polytray wheelbarrow, $49.94. Assorted power tools, $14.88 each.
Helping the customers get what they actually need.
Bunnings Warehouse!
Lowest prices are just the beginning.
Now is the time to sign up for a Bravo. It's the Mazda Bravo Diesel Runout. Get huge bonuses on all diesel Bravos. 4x4 and 4x2 Bravos. Single cab, twin cab or freestyle cab. Plus great deals on V6 petrol Bravos. This is the sign you've been waiting for. The Mazda Bravo Diesel Runout. For huge savings, see your Mazda dealer now.
Are you looking for a milk with no fat that tastes great? Switch to Paul's Slim Milk. Paul's Slim Milk contains no fat and no cholesterol, making it a healthy part of your diet. With more calcium than full cream milk, Paul's Slim keeps you looking good and feeling great without compromising on taste. Plus, it has a low GI for sustained energy release. For a simple way to make a healthy change to your lifestyle, look for Paul's Slim Milk in your supermarket today. Brand Power, helping you buy better.
Announcing Jetstar's Choices, Choices, Choices sale. Choose from a whole range of fantastic destinations within Australia from just $39. To make your choice, visit jetstar.com.
Coles has 2,000 specials every week. Like John West Tuna Tempters, 100 gram, only 99 cents each. Save 60 cents each. And new season Loose Sundowner Apples, just $2.89 a kilo. This week only at Coles.
Sunday, The journey goes further than ever.
Come with me.
Back 125 million years. Prehistoric Park. Sunday, 6:30.
Channel 9.
Well, welcome back to Riverfire. Not long now until the fireworks go off. Now, the organisers of River Festival are always on the lookout for new ideas, and this year has been no exception. They've got 26 high school students, and what they've done is gone on an adventure tracking the whole of the Brisbane River from its source in the Bunya Mountains down to Moreton Bay. Now, the idea of the journey is to help answer the question, what is happening to our waterways? Now, the Shack's eco-expert Jackie Duncan has caught up with the adventurers, and she started out with them before they started their epic adventure.
Ambassadors spent 2 days at the Stanley River Environmental Education Centre near Kilcoy. This part of southeast Queensland has really felt the effects of the drought. It probably did make them ask, what is the future of our waterways?
This is the first time the young ambassadors have come together, and it's very much a city meets country affair. Over the next 2 days, they'll be getting a crash course in canoeing, bushcraft, and learning how to use some pretty high-tech equipment.
After meeting their travelling companions, the students were assigned their areas of responsibility for the trip. Some will be observing plant life, water quality, and insects. Others will be making a photographic record of their journey.
What sort of photographs will you be taking?
We'll be taking photographs of the entire journey and everyone in it.
And what will you be doing with those photos?
During the journey, we'll be uploading them onto the River Festival website.
And then at the end of it, we'll have a huge digital scrapbook.
The group's been together for about 5 hours now. They're starting to get to know each other and they've met their mentors, but now it's time for some water skills.
Hold on, now your exit's here. It's waiting just for you.
Before the drought, they would have had to walk a couple of hundred metres, but the water has receded so much, it's a kilometre trek to the banks of the dam. Some of the students have paddled before. For others, it's just one of the new experiences.
Soon you'll see. Even though the drought means these guys won't be able to travel the full length of the river by canoe, over half the journey will be done by paddle power.
And how do you think you'd go doing a couple of hundred kilometres of that?
No way.
Are you retiring?
We were just out there today. You've got a lot further to go.
A lot.
It'll be hard, but it'll be good.
Soon you'll see.
The young ambassadors don't just need the skills to get from Bunya to the bay. They also need to know how to cook food so they don't starve along the way. They're inside preparing dinner right now. This is going to be interesting.
From paddling to peeling, it's ironic the rain has sent them inside. Not enough to put the campfire out though. An hour and a half later and dinner is served. Chicken and veggie casserole with hot damper, all cooked in the camp ovens. That should fill their stomachs. They need the sustenance though, because there's another big day ahead tomorrow. You'll see. Day two saw the group learning to use the GPS units they'll be taking on the journey.
We're going south.
The global positioning system will allow them to record accurately anything of interest they find along the way.
This is far more than a big adventure and team building exercise. Once these guys have biked, hiked and paddled their way to Moreton Bay, they would have collected information and photographs that can be accessed by the appropriate authorities. It's going to be a whole lot of fun though. Wish I could join them.
Well, Jackie's now down in the crowd at South Bank. Jackie, that looked like quite a trip of your head. How they're going?
Oh, they're going really well, Heather. Currently they're at Wivenhoe Dam, about halfway along their journey, and they're watching the River Fire from there tonight. Hi guys!
Isn't that amazing that they can see it from Wivenhoe? Now, where and when does their trip officially end?
Well, it ends tomorrow week at Fort Lytton, and I will be there to congratulate them on officially becoming our first river ambassadors.
Well, thanks, Jackie. Well, we wish them all luck. Sounds like a great trip, and we'll see them soon. So we'll have more after the break as we count down to River Fire, coming up soon.
The dust from a distant sun will shower over everyone.
Cashed up bogans. How these working class larrikins became Australia's new rich.
As hard as we work is as much as we earn.
And the amazing breakthrough to losing weight and keeping it off forever.
In 4 weeks, you can change your life.
A Current Affair Monday.
This is my brother Andrew. Andrew didn't believe for a minute that our hospital system would let him die. Now he's dead, and I blame Peter Beattie.
Andrew Stanley was another Queenslander who died waiting for urgent surgery.
Andrew didn't get another chance, and neither should Peter Beattie.
Authorised G Green, Queensland Coalition, Brisbane.
Want to get a fully loaded Nissan deal? For the first time, you can get a Nissan Tita ST sedan or hatch from just $17,990. The Tita is the Pulsar replacement and it's better value than ever. The ST has a powerful and economical 1.8-litre engine, dual airbags, air conditioning, CD player, 6-speed manual, plus loads and loads of space. The Nissan Tita is now from just $17,990 and it's loaded up with value.
Announcing Jetstar's Choices, Choices, Choices sale. Choose from a whole range of fantastic destinations within Australia from just $39. To make your choice, visit jetstar.com.
Check this out.
Dads just can't get enough of Super Cheap Auto this Father's Day. This Kenwood MP3 CD player is just $149 and this 67-piece toolkit just $67. That's a dollar a tool.
To demonstrate just how much fruity flavour is crammed into Kellogg's whole grain mini wheats, we crammed Dana and Dave's breakup into 30 seconds.
We need to talk.
Yes.
I'm really busy at the moment and don't have time for a girlfriend.
Are you breaking up with me?
Yeah, I guess.
Oh my gosh, I'm so upset.
Well, we've only been together 2 days.
They were the best 2 days of my life.
Well, we can still be friends.
Whatever. You're too short for me anyway.
Yeah, well, I'm with Karen now.
Well, I'm with someone else too.
Yeah, right, who?
Benjamin? Will you go out with me?
Okay.
Mini wheats.
Maxi taste!
On 60 Minutes, how you can tell if your young bloke's gay.
He's gay.
Also, the secret life of a megastar.
Don't go there, right?
But why the dummy spit?
You are a loser.
60 Minutes, Sunday on 9.
Welcome back to River Fire 2006. Now, the river's certainly become a popular place to play for Brisbaneites and visitors alike. Here at Kangaroo Point is the River Life Adventure Centre, and they have some great new toys. And who better to try them out than the shack's biggest kid, Beau Walker.
With parks and pathways on both sides of the water, it's pretty easy to get up close to our river. It's a backdrop for walkers, riders, rollerbladers, and even rock climbers. But if you really want a close personal experience with the river, you have to actually get on it. So I'm going to try two types of transport, one old and one very new.
The River Life Adventure Centre at the base of Kangaroo Point Cliffs can set you up for just about any kind of river adventure. Today, instructor Chris Mason is going to share the delights of kayaking on the city reach of the river.
All right, mate, you'll need one of these before we get started. Just slip it over the head. I'm just going to jump in the boat here, show you a couple of things.
Beautiful.
Okay. So in the seat, making sure the seat's nice and tight, unclipping the paddle from the inside, bringing it across in front of you, steel button in the middle, hands about shoulder width apart. We're going to bring the paddle in at the toe, nice long stroke back past the hip. Roll it over on the other side.
Looks pretty stable.
It's very stable. These Hobies are great.
You don't need any previous experience to go out on the kayaks, but you must be at least 8 years old. Single and double kayaks are available, and you can either join an instruction session or head out on your own. And I just wanna wish you well.
So, Chris, where are we heading today?
Well, Bo, today we're going to head down under the Story Bridge to the end of the floating walkway around Bulimba there.
Before you start out, it's best to check which way the tide's flowing, so you can choose a direction that will have you paddling home with a little less effort.
If
I'm scared of a big fairy coming over. What do we do?
They're pretty easy to stay out of the way of. As long as you stay to the outer thirds of the river, that'll keep you away from them most of the time.
The kayaks are fitted with a drink carrier, so don't forget some water and wear some shoes and clothes that can get wet. Sunscreen's a must, unless you're headed out for a night paddle.
It's just beautiful being out on the river at night. You've got the city and the bridge all lit up.
Story Bridge.
Story Bridge it is.
River fire, it's gonna look spectacular. Chris, it's pretty cool just cruising at your own pace on the river, eh?
Oh, it's been a great morning out here.
Great morning. I've got to tell you, I'm having a lot of fun.
Yeah, you're looking for fun, mate? I've got something else that we can try.
Mate, what is this?
Good question. This is our new toy. It's called a pumper bike. Made in South Africa, human-powered hydroplane.
It looks bizarre, mate. How does it work?
It's very strange. Well, actions speak louder than words, so let's give it a go.
Okay.
The pumper bike is made from aluminium and plastic and weighs just 14 kilos, and it can travel up to 30 kilometers per hour. The hydrofoils act like wings and propel you over the water using your pumping action as the engine. Simple, right?
Oh,
there's no pumping about it!
It's more about technique than strength, so be prepared to get wet till you get the hang of it. Once you do, you could be racing the city cats.
Start turning, start turning!
Right now, I'd be happy just to get back to dry land.
I told you I'd get up close and personal to the river, and this is one very unique way of doing it.
The pumper bikes are coming to South Bank. Look out for them and grab your chance to race some mates over the river.
Oh, he's a clown, isn't he?
I don't know about that.
Cleo, potential bachelor of the year, I don't know. Well, listen, the clock's ticking down. The F111s are in the air not long now before the city lights up.
Stay with us. We'll be back after the break with River Fire 2006.
Tuesday night, it's all about 20 to 1.
Ooh-wee.
These allegations are false.
Yeah.
An all-new season on an all-new night.
All-new 20 to 1.
Tuesday, 7:30 on 9.
The new Kia Magentis. Luxury is standard from $25,990, backed by a 5-year Kia factory warranty. The new Kia Magentis, the power to surprise.
This weekend at Super A-Mart, we're spring cleaning. Current floor stock models marked down to clear. Lounges, sofas, dining, bedding, outdoor and more. All reduced. Come wheel and deal. No deposit, up to 2 years interest free. This weekend only, Super A-Mart.
For the first time ever in Queensland, experience the amazing human body, an anatomical display of real human bodies. This educational exhibition provides you with a unique perspective on the inner workings of the human body by previewing real human specimens preserved through the plastination process. Avoid the queues and reserve your tickets at Ticket Tech by phone or online. The Amazing Human Body Exhibition, on now till October 22nd at RNA Showgrounds, getting under your skin.
During Toyota's Something for Everyone September, you're sure to find the right car at the right price. All versatile Kluger models are now available with a super affordable finance offer of just 4.9% per annum. And if you want 8-seat capacity and the choice of petrol or turbo diesel models, Prado GXL is the four-wheel drive for you from just $49,990. Get into Toyota's Something for Everyone September and pack more into your life.
This weekend at Super A-Mart, we're spring cleaning. Current floor stock models marked down to clear. Lounges, sofas, dining, bedding, outdoor and more. All reduced. Come wheel and deal. No deposit, up to 2 years interest free. This weekend only, Super A-Mart.
Things get hairy when cats take on dogs. Funny Show videos next on 9.
Thank you.
welcome back to River Fire. It's the official start of River Festival, and that is 10 days of activities.
Yeah, wonderful stuff. The Portside Wharf is a stylish new facility on the river. It only opened on Tuesday, and the shack style princess, Kendall Nagorka, was there.
Good on you.
Impressions are always important, whether it be meeting someone for the first time or arriving at a foreign port. It's fair to say, until recently, visitors arriving in Brisbane by passenger ship didn't get to see our best side. But now, thanks to the $750 million Portside Wharf development, Brisbane is able to welcome cruise ships and their passengers in style. The Pacific Star is the first to dock at the new terminal, bringing the first of an estimated 120,000 visitors a year.
It's really looking good. 60 ships in the next 12 months, 55 this year, and it's very positive. The response from the industry has been fantastic. This ship here is 204 metres long, which is relatively small. Okay. The benchmark ship that we can cater for is 270 metres. Now we can take pretty much every ship that cruises in the Australian waters.
Portside Wharf is not just for visitors, there's plenty here for locals to enjoy.
Our vision was to create a destination for the people of Brisbane and make it a very public place. And that's why, you know, our involvement with Riverfire this year is so exciting, that we can get the people of Brisbane to come down, see what's happening down here, get out on the wharf and actually experience Riverfire.
Yeah, it is a great new venue. It's going to be a new location for Riverfire, so it's going to be the biggest Riverfire ever. We're bringing fireworks down here, so people will get fireworks from Toowong all the way down here.
With the Pacific Star back at sea, the wharf will be opened up to give everyone a new vantage point for River Fire and a new venue for River Festival.
There's semillon and seafood over this weekend here at Portside. You can sample lots of wonderful semillon, and there'll be free entertainment all weekend.
With restaurants, a bakery, a fresh food market, cinemas, boutiques, and an undeniably great buzz, Portside has instantly become Brisbane's newest foodie precinct. Now, with all this excitement, you may not want to leave. So if you're quick, you could still make this your brand new home. Portside Wharf has three residential buildings and stage one has only eight left. So, like I said, if you're quick, this could be your new view. Getting closer to the water has become an increasingly important part of people's shopping and dining experience. Now, thanks to Portside Wharf, yet another stretch of the beautiful Brisbane River is open for business.
Looks good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Very interesting. Now, they all seem as excited as the rest of us down there, don't they?
I know, guys. How are you going? Now, two of you haven't been to a river fire before, I understand.
No, we haven't been before. Bo and myself have not been, so we're very, very excited. We can't wait to see the fireworks.
I'm very excited, I've got to tell you.
I know, I mean, you know, before. We've all seen fireworks before, but until you see a river fire that just goes for half an hour from millions of places, it's really awesome. Yeah.
Quick word to Bo, you're going to have to do a bit of practice on that boat thing.
Easy, mate, easy.
Okay. I don't think the word battler comes into it. No, no, that's fine. But no, you're going to have a wonderful time. So thanks, guys. The F-111s are in the air, so we should be on the final countdown about now.
It'll be coming through any minute.
So get those radios tuned to Triple M. That's 104.5 on the FM dial and standby Brisbane. You're about to have the city turned into a city of blinding lights. And here we go.
Riverfire 2006.
River Fire Control to crew of Fire 1, over.
River Fire Control, this is Fire 1. 20 elevator level, over Sunnybank, on final approach.
River Fire Control operations, please confirm with Land Based Police that all bridges are now closed and all road closures and diversions are in place, over.
Confirmed, land locations are secure. Water Based Police Command have secured all spectator and commercial craft in designated mooring zones. River is closed between West End and East Brisbane and the Hamilton Reach is secure. City Cats have ceased operation and all six fireworks barges are in position. Over.
Please confirm all commercial air traffic is in a holding pattern.
Check.
Channel 9 camera and production team are ready to go.
Check.
And Triple M soundtrack ready to roll.
Ready.
River Fire Control Centre, this is Fody Fireworks. Confirming all fireworks launching systems are live. Circuits testing completed. All bridges, barges and rooftops are ready to go.
What about that for a knockout opening?
Great.
Welcome to Brisbane River's Night of Nights, River Fire 2006. I'm Bruce Page from National 9 News.
And I'm Heather Ford to once again bring you this spectacular event.
As big as River Fire is, it's just the beginning of a full 8 days of activities and entertainment that make up the whole of the 2006 River Festival.
It's all about celebrating the life-giving waterway at the heart of our city, the beautiful Brisbane River.
In just a moment, we're going to kick off some more amazing fireworks. Firstly, a reminder that tonight's event is being simulcast on Triple M FM.
So, tune in to Channel 9 if you're at home, but wherever you are, turn up your radio.
Now, it's over to Triple M's Ian Skippen and The Cage.
Thanks, Bruce. Thanks, Heather. And thank you to everybody who's come out tonight to help us make it such a big one. And we're all here.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi there. We're all very excited.
All right.
It's way past our bedtime. We've had fizzy drinks and there's about to be fireworks.
Yeah, so let's go. Hey. Lock it on the Triple M and enjoy River Fire 2006. Light the wick and...
Love forever, love is breathing, sun forever, you and me. Windmill, windmill, father.
There's nothing but the rain, no footsteps on the ground. I'm listening, but there's no sound. Isn't anyone trying to find me? Won't somebody come take me?
Hundreds of kilometres away from here, in a place of misty, majestic rainforests and crisp mountain air. Wallabies and wildlife roam. Hundreds of colourful tropical birds flutter in the trees. Feel the dreaming of those who used this as a feasting and gathering place for many thousands of years. Here begins the story of our river. A rainstorm high in the Bunya Mountains. Water trickles slowly from leaf to leaf down into tiny puddles and streams. creeks join with one another to begin our river's journey from Bunya to the bay.
As part of this year's River Festival, for the first time ever, 30 Queensland school students are undertaking an amazing 330-kilometre journey along the entire length of the Brisbane River.
It's awesome, isn't it? They go from the Bunya Mountains through farming country, national parks and lots of river communities until finally they arrive here in Brisbane.
Well, tonight they're taking a well-earned rest at Wivenhoe Dam, so join us in wishing our eco-investigators well for the next 8 days.
Yep, they're going to continue their unique environmental adventure all the way to Moreton Bay.
Hi, my name is Kerry and I'm from Mergan State High School and I'm proud to be part of the Bunya to the Bay event for the River Festival.
Happy River Festival!
Tell me all the things you would change. I don't pretend to know what you want. You come around and smell my talk. Time and again, time and again. Not far away, I lit my spark. I am not afraid of the dark. But your words devour my heart and put me to shame, put me to shame. And you're seven roots to
bad taste in your mouth. You act like you never had love, and you want me.
The river is growing, slowly wider and stronger as it progresses down the mountains. The mighty Wivenhoe Dam harnesses the power of the river and provides precious water to millions. Through the foothills of the Diagla Range, the river runs on to Mount Crosby, bushland home of birds, flying foxes, rock wallabies and possums. Finally, it reaches the suburbs of our hometown. You may drive past it daily and not even notice, but whether in peak hour traffic or the middle of the night, the creeks that fed into the river continue to flow. Oxley, Anagra, Norman, Bulimba, Ithaca, and many more. The sounds of the city mix with the sounds of our river. From the Bunya Mountains to the bay, our magnificent river is here for all of us to enjoy and care for. River Festival 2006 is officially open. Let the celebrations begin. We'll be right back.
Foley for a final five.
Fire one, this is the Cajun, Triple M with Ian Skippen, and they're letting us guide them in this year.
No, not a good idea.
Turn it up that way, have a go.
Okay. Just give them the go-ahead, Skip. Come on, let's go.
Fire one, listen carefully. Go north and veer left at Cleveland and head towards the city. Just look for the bright lights.
Yeah, that'll do.
That's okay, guys. We don't need directions. We'll see you in a few minutes. Get your cameras ready, Bridget.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, on behalf of River Festival's foundation sponsors, the Queensland Government,
the Brisbane City Council,
and Channel 9, thank you for being part of Brisbane's biggest night of the year.
Simulcast right here on Channel 9 and Triple M. Enjoy the next 8 days of River Festival.
OK, thank you, Bruce. Do I have to press anything?
No! No.
Well, what's this button here, then?
Oh, it's something to do with the football. Grand final.
The grand finale.
Whatever it is, just bring it on. There it goes!
Strong.
Told you they wouldn't get lost. Well done, guys.
Thanks for fire control.
We have the river. 1, 2, 3 bridges target in sight.
Want one of those after me.
Oh, aren't they fantastic? And especially down here in the city, all the fireworks are reflecting off all the glass windows. It just looked amazing.
I think the eyebrows
it?
Are sense, are they?
That's right, and you can pick up your dogs. They're halfway to Morton Island right now.
So oh, good fun. Great fun.
We've had a lovely time too, and Channel 9's been a proud part of River Fire and the River Festival for the past 9 years. It's just been fantastic, and we love bringing the coverage for you tonight.
Absolutely. About 50 of our colleagues have been involved bringing tonight's amazing coverage, so thanks to them, guys.
There are also some other people we should thank too. Jones Lang LaSalle, GPT Property Management, Transfield, Stefan Spotless Property Management, South Bank Corporation and South Bank TAFE, because
without them we wouldn't have such great camera positions to capture the show from every angle.
It has been fantastic.
It's been
wonderful. Tune in to National 9 News for all the highlights tomorrow and all the other highlights of the River Festival about to come.
Time to go. I guess we should say
good night. I hope you enjoyed it. We loved it.
Absolutely.
See you then.
Wonderful.
Of local news.
Every night at 6, we're committed to bringing you the best local coverage and exclusive reports.
More local sport and weather forecasts on the weekend. Queensland's own Extra is your community voice. And the Gold Coast's only local news. We're everywhere.
Because we're part of Queensland.
Up next at the special time, funniest home videos. Then our star-studded movie, Pay It Forward, tonight on Channel 9.